Ooh, Welcome back to the TI5 Chinese Qualifier. I'm Luminous, your host, that gives sponsor shoutouts. That's the only one. I'm the only one that gives sponsor shoutouts, right?
I guess.
Yeah.
Solid king of the day.
He's probably the
I'm
only
just
one.
Doing my job.
I'd say he's probably the only one with the job at the end of the day.
Yeah,
so.
I'm joined by God, Sindarin, and Andy, or Drasco, as per usual. What's cracking, guys? You were doing Carcassonne counting.
Yeah.
Who won?
I think I won.
Okay.
I'm not done counting, but.
Okay.
But he didn't guaranteed win. Because somebody else got his piece. I was watching.
Yeah.
Actually, I have no idea. How
I still think
works.
I got it.
All right. So we were talking about the energy pacemaker versus wings, game number one. What they could do different. You talked about potentially contesting a jungle. You know, is Chen something that you can really expect coming out of them two games in a row, though? Because you said it is very uncommon right now.
But Super is a player that could play it. One of the few players that plays it. So, yeah. You can't
okay.
expect the two games. If
I'm curious if Wings are going to say, okay, Chen work, let's go for the Chen again. If they're going to say, let's go for another one of our strats. Like, they've done a lot of, like, the IO Tiny in the past with Super playing the IO, XDD playing Tiny. Like, I'm just curious if they're a team who's going to say, well, this worked in game one, let's do the same thing game two, or let's go for our secondary strategy so they can't prepare for what we just did.
I'm wondering if Chen was the backup plan. Like, if he wasn't, like...
Maybe.
It didn't look like it's what they set out to do. He wasn't, like, a fantastic pick from the draft at that point. It was just solid. I guess, how often do you really feel like, wow, Chen is like godlike right here?
But they also picked it after the DK and the gyro clock, right? That was when they picked it.
I think so.
Yeah, so I would actually argue that it's a very good hero to pick in that situation.
Because of all the AoE damage.
You already know that the clockwork is going to be like solo offlane. There's not really many things they had to pair
That's
with
true.
It that would have pressured the safe lane that well. So I think it was actually a very good situation for them.
Okay. Oh, we'll see if they do it again. They have started the draft. Wings Gaming are going to ban the Windranger again against Energy Pacemaker.
Did
trade-off?
Energy takes
Dark
Zero AA. Yeah, these bans make no sense. Are they trying to do... okay. Well, I guess they have first pick, right?
So this is like when you have like the two teams who kind of know each other really well and they just start banning heroes where it's like, why are they banning these heroes? It makes... Like in the greater scheme of Dota 2, it makes absolutely no sense. But with these two teams knowing each other, they probably maybe scrimmed a lot coming in or whatever. It's probably a case of just... targeted bans based on their knowing their opponents as well as they do.
This has to be like Gyro plus one, right?
Yeah.
Like 100% Gyro plus one.
Gyro clock seems like pretty solid. It lost last game.
It did lose last game, but you said Energy Pacemaker don't run Chen. So maybe if Super is the only person in this game who can even play the Chen hero, is it still good to pick?
I would definitely say Gyro. He seems like a solid pick against Undying in general, Flak Cannon working and all. And
it's also just a really good laner. And a lot of carry like pickers or carry players, they don't get the hero that can actually match up against the Undying in the safe lane, and they end up getting punished really hard for it.
Yeah.
Like, even heroes like Juggernaut, sure, you can commit all in for a kill, but if you don't actually get it, sometimes the lane can get turned on you. So,
I'm not sure about the clockwork, though. I think cogs a lot of time could mess you up, especially there's a tombstone on the other side of the cogs.
Yeah, you definitely need to play around it. That's true. I'm just wondering what would be a better choice. I also wouldn't mind seeing something like Gyro Chen. It's probably too early for them to pick the right?
Tiny?
Oh, okay.
Okay. That's
another.
Well, they've won with this too. So
yeah.
Yeah, it's they. I think it's partly just not wanting to do the same thing they did game one. Make it harder. Well, I guess EP now can prepare for the higher Tiny, but.
Okay, so what's good against Wisp Tiny then?
Disruptor, Gyro, anything that has a setup, pretty much.
I saw like, TV's win to Wyvern. That was actually pretty good against Wisp
Tiny.
Yeah,
Wyvern's really good as well.
I don't know if EP play that. I don't think so.
I don't think Wyvern, like, yeah, it's a hero you might have to get used to playing, but I don't think it has a super high skill cap. And they're just going to go with a second pick Viper.
I think landing Splinter Blast in fights, chaotic fights, could be difficult.
It's everything he has is such long range, though. Like, you pretty much can sit as far away as you want and be able to use all your spells.
The travel time of that spell is really slow. Like, it has to hit a thing, and then it pops out.
Yeah, I mean, like, if you land a Winter's Curse, it should pretty much guarantee your Splinter Blast, right?
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Your Arctic Burn as well.
But during Splinter or during Curse, they all take 70% less damage, right? Isn't that it?
Yeah.
All the taunted ones. So you want to time it so it lands after the curse ends.
Yeah.
But yeah. Landing a Winter's Curse is actually not as easy as you may think because, like, the cast range of it isn't extremely high. And
well, in this game, heroes need to position it's themselves. Still just a disable. And even if it's not hitting other heroes nearby, it's still like a mini roar at that point.
Oh, yeah.
I don't think you have to be... The hero isn't decided based on hitting Winter's Curse on 3 to 4 heroes.
No, but it definitely helps.
Yeah, yeah. He's just nice against the Tiny. You can block the physical damage, and it just allows you to lock down the Tiny with the Winter's Curse, and then while that's going on, find the Wisp and try to focus him down.
The main thing you need to be careful with is that if you miss time Cold Embrace, you basically set up for a free Avatos combo.
Yeah.
And that is going to destroy pretty much, like... I can't remember what the full damage is of Avatos when you have level 1 grow and both abilities on level 4, but I would imagine, like, most heroes will lose all of their health, if not like 80%, apart from a hero like Viper. Or if Undying has decayed a couple of times, maybe he's fine. And maybe that's the idea even for Energy Pacemaker, that they just pick a lot of very tanky heroes and just try to 5-man early while Tiny isn't so strong.
They don't get hit by the extra hit by... Because Cold Embrace protects it of the Avatos combo.
Which
you still get hit by the full combo.
Yeah?
He's saying
the
get
auto hit when you
the auto hit, yeah.
Yeah, I think he was referring to grow in the sense that the toss damage does more.
Yeah.
And ooh. They are going just tanky, hard-to-kill heroes against the Tiny.
Bristle is really good against Tiny. Is actually one of the few heroes that can, in the early mid-game, can take him in a fist fight and actually expect to go in and be able to take the fight, not dying to everyone else. It's one thing if your hero can match up against Tiny in an isolated one-on-one, but Dota generally doesn't go that way. But if you can fight Tiny while you have the back on the rest of the enemies, that can be really powerful. And they obviously have the Viper Strike against the Tiny, so Bristleback should have a pretty clear advantage in that. It's also a hero that can run down the Wisp. That's important, too.
Do you really think that Wisp is a hero where... if you come into a game with a strategy of saying, okay, we're going to play Tiny Wisp, do you just always think that you have to show it in the first two? Or do you think that most teams, maybe in China, wouldn't respect the Wisp enough to ban it?
I was thinking they could pick it second phase here. I was thinking about bringing it up, but I think they might just get it banned in the second phase sometimes, but yeah, I would agree. Like, considering...
I don't know if you can guarantee it with this team, because Super and XDD, like, even going back to DT Club during last TI qualifiers, they were running Wisp Tiny, like, maybe 1 in 3 games or something. Like, it's a known strategy with these players, at least.
Okay.
So, any other team, I think, sure, but with this team, I don't think there's a guarantee you get the Wisp still available in the second stage.
Are you guys surprised at all that Queen of Pain was picked into the Viper?
No. I think it's
the laning
actually,
is...
But outside of the lane, like, look past the laning phase. What do they have to kill Queen?
Well, and who says Queen of Pain's even going mid, too?
Yeah.
Well, it could be Tiny Wisp going mid, yeah.
Safe lane Queen of Pain.
Quap's actually even good in the off lane so far on Radiant. I'm a pretty big fan of running Quap off lane when you're Radiant. I think it's pretty weak on Dire, but if Energy Pacemaker... Like, if one of your supports is Undying, he does nothing against Quap at all. Okay, now it's probably safe lane, but they could even run the bat safe. That does make it unlikely.
Is this the first Batrider pick? I have not seen Batrider.
It's been one.
Okay.
Seen it yesterday, I think.
So this kind of...
That was one yesterday. They lost. That was the Tinker strat? Or no, they won. They played it against the Tinker strat.
It was Wings versus C-Deck. It was one of the closer matches.
Maybe you're thinking of two different games.
Yeah.
The
game
then.
You're talking about and the game I'm talking about. Is
yeah, there was the a Batrider against the Tinker game.
Yeah, this was Tinker Beastmaster and stuff, and they beat that. I can't remember. Tinker Beastmaster was run by Tongfu Wanzhou, and I can't remember what team beat them. I think it was... No, it wasn't Wings. Was it Energy Pacemaker?
It was a Group A team, so it could have been EP.
I think it was EP, actually. No. Regardless, we've seen it twice then.
Okay.
I think Batrider or any hero that just goes on Undying early to shut him out is really, really good in a team fight.
So possible dual lanes with the Jakira Undying. Doesn't give them a good answer for the Batrider. Like, they could have gone for like a Venge or a Rubik, something with like a instant kind of disable to try and counter out the Batrider, but Jakiro, so-so.
I think Energy Pacemaker are tunnel visioning really hard right now. They're like, we need to beat Io Tiny in the lane. But what do they do if Wings Gaming put the lanes in a way they don't expect? Actually, Jakiro is really bad for dual lane mid, right? Doesn't really offer that much. So if they put Io Tiny mid and the Jakiro is picked to go with Undying and beat the Io Tiny, what if you just put Quap against that lane? She doesn't care. Just free farms, more or less. I mean, they can obviously get some denies, but they definitely can't kill her. Bristleback loses to Quap one-on-one in lane, so that's not an option either. Then you're looking at either offlaning a Viper or losing that lane, while Io Tiny or fine mid and Batrider will create chaos top. I think this Jakiro pick was really bad, to be honest.
I don't think they're really focusing so much on lane at all. I think they're looking more at like the mid-game timing where your Viper potentially has a mech or Bristleback, depending on who buys it, and you just go in with Liquid Fire and you try to 5-man. Because I think fighting in to Energy Pacemaker's team could be relatively difficult. And I do think that Wings, they have really squishy heroes outside of the Tiny, right? Like Bat Queen, Io, they can't really commit to a fight unless you kill a hero like straight off the bat. So I think to a degree, they might not get the best lanes, but I think their mid game will be very, very hard to deal with.
But that's just not Energy Pacemaker's strength, right?
I mean, Wings are scared
of it. They're picking weak lanes.
They're taking out Rasta. I mean, like, can you imagine that a 5-man push with your tower, with Serpent Wards, Liquid Fire in tower, with Bristleback Tomb backup?
I definitely agree. Like, if Energy Pacemaker get through the early game well, and they're looking good coming into the mid game, they can force down towers. I'm just worried that if they put their lanes wrong, they're actually going to win zero lanes, or maybe win one that isn't even that important, and then they won't even get to that state where they feel like they can confidently push.
Oh, I do feel Wings fall off pretty, Energy Pacemaker fall off pretty significantly if they don't start getting momentum. Like, this team has such susceptibility to being kited that it's unreal, even with an Abaddon pick as well. Like,
that's
this
a good pick.
Yeah, it can be kited, though. It's great against the bat, obviously. Good at being able to remove like random things like Fissure Stuns, Queen Dagger. It's just good for the tankiness in general for the team. And I think that Jakiro was really only put in as a guaranteed push. Like, just, okay, we get this tower no matter what. And I think if they can kind of use that momentum, I think they have a chance.
Does seem kind of cheesy and all-in-ish. Like, the late game, I guess Viper Bristleback kind of go late game if you're ahead already, but if they don't get that early advantage and start snowballing, like, I don't see any kind of comeback potential with their draft.
Bristleback with Abaddon is a really strong pairing, though. Even in a dual lane offlane. Now they might have actually solved the laning problem, because this Abaddon could win them another lane. And their Viper, if the Viper doesn't play against Wisp Tiny, he'll probably win his lane too. And then maybe we're looking at a position where instead of winning one lane and looking grim, if they win two lanes and get levels on the key support, Abaddon and I guess Jakiro is a support on Dying Zakor, I don't know. I mean, one or the other. Then they could look really, really hot with a fast mech maybe in this game, I guess.
I mean,
the Viper.
You guys are saying like the Abaddon helps you win lane. I see it. Well, when you normally say win a lane, you talk more about like, oh, I got maybe a level extra, maybe 10 more CS. But when you have the Abaddon winning lanes for you, that's when like tower diving is happening with Bristleback or Undying.
Yes.
And when you win the lane, you win it really hard. And I think that's what EP needs, right?
Yeah. I think they definitely need to lane him with Bristle.
And Wings, this is where the last pick, Urshake, it's a defensive support, but it's not a good support to fight it against that kind of aggression. So this Urshake could be a big liability.
Yeah, it is looking to be a farming Jakiro, by the way, at least for the people playing the heroes right now. Fans playing Jakiro.
Yeah. Okay.
I think
does that mean it's safe lane?
It could be.
He plays safe lane every time, right?
Can this be offensive tri lane? Or is that just too...
What do you think? Jakiro like, bat and Undying?
It's more who do you solo against bat then at that point.
Like, old chicken is Bristle. So I don't know if they're... like. I just feel like all the games we've seen EP, old chicken goes mid, fan goes safe lane.
Yeah.
And... what is it, Small 2 Thunder, I think it is, goes offlane. But they've swapped things around here. So this makes me think either they aggressive trialing the Viper, or they... I really don't think they put the Bristle mid. I just think that's a really bad idea. He does not do well against Swiss Tiny.
Bristle safe lane versus bat, and then that's offensive trialing. I mean, Viper still kind of has to go mid against the Io Tiny, which isn't... I mean, no one really...
No one can do that lane, if that's what they do.
Yeah.
So. Yeah.
That's interesting. I think the laning phase will dictate definitely a lot for this game, like no matter what. If Energy Pacemaker get the lanes that they want and good matchups, I think it will be very difficult for Wings to do anything. Like God's mentioned, the Shaker, I can see that hero being almost a non-factor, depending on how hard the 5-man is from EP.
If he starts getting died by Bristleback or just Undying starts running at him, he's just going to... He can't do anything except throw a Fissure and run. Or just run and hope he doesn't get caught up to. But And that's where you guys mentioned they've got a lot of squishy heroes. That's Undying going to be having a great time this game.
All right. Looks like the game's going to be underway. It's going to be Wings taking on Energy Pacemaker game number 2. Lumi, second game in the series. Who do you think's got it?
I'm still running with my 2-0 pick dictionary with Wings. I think even though EP could run away with the game simply from the laning stage, I think Wings is overall the better team and could climb their way back if that happens.
Okay. And so far, everyone's kind of assuming, like Syndrome was saying, fan safe lane pretty often. Old Chicken going safe lane pretty much all the time. I mean, there's no real change up in lanes from EP. Their lanes, if anything, are predictable in a way. Do you think that hurts them against Wings?
Yeah, it seems like in July is going to be the safe laner. So if they're running offensive trialing against a Batrider, I think the Bat... I mean, that's probably the best matchup. Well, not the best matchup. I think that's what Wings wanted. So that kind of predictability is coming back to hurt them.
So even be doing it right now. Like, nope, we don't want any part of this. We want to at least match up lane versus lane.
Yep.
I do like the way that Energy Pacemaker picked Undying, though. I mean, usually when you pick it first, it seems like one of those heroes that you have a really hard time trying to fight around because you don't usually have a lot of things that can make you commit to a fight. But having the capability of just pushing makes the enemy team want to fight. Look at what Wings did in game 1. They make Energy Pacemaker fight because they're always pushing, always taking towers. And Fissure here on the fan, he gets tossed up to the high ground. What a play! Are you kidding me?
We're not even at TI5 yet. This is just the qualifiers.
This is a pocket strat. Okay, he's actually losing this right click fight. He's going to have to blink down.
I think this is better. I think this is vastly better.
Yeah, okay. They take the majority of his health. Maybe not the best choice. Okay.
Time to just
they
drop,
already got a TP.
Drop the mic and just...
They got a TP. Okay. It was cool, but...
By the way, that makes no sense. You can't just pass a TP up a cliff like that.
Well, he hasn't yet. There we go.
Where's the second toss? You know, this is how it's supposed to happen.
Oh, he mistimed it. He might have been assuming that he was going for a TP, but...
But look at this. This is so much time wasted already.
Yeah, of course.
Oh, actually, he TP'd the safe lane, so maybe not.
Okay, so he's going to miss what? Maybe half of one creep wave? No, he TP'd off lane. Yeah.
Oh, okay. This is the matchup they
want. Oh, you mean he TP'd safe wings. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. And then, so... Yeah, in terms of the new lanes that's formed... I think that's kind of what EP wanted.
I don't know if Bristleback... He might not do great against this lane mid, but...
But he's the only one that could do okay against
it. Yeah, I don't think he dies either, right? Because he gets an early bottle, just crows it out, has a lot of HP, gets a couple of points, and a Bristleback. Diving him is super dangerous.
And then for the Viper versus Quap, you know, the lane should go to the Viper.
I would say in middle lane, it might be a bit easier even for the Viper than in a 1v1 offlane situation. But I guess he does have a support there as well.
Yep. So despite the early game shenanigans, I think EP is happy with what they got. And as long as Old Chicken gets to bottle, I think things should
be... He has
be.
It already, right?
Oh, yeah, he does. Okay, yeah, he should be fine. I might even pick up a magic stick just to be safe, but...
The thing about Bristle, though, is you can't continue spamming like that against this lane, because the Wisp and the Tiny will both eventually get sticks, and then you pretty much cannot start quilling unless you're going in for a kill. Because otherwise, it's just like infinite mana for both heroes, and even health.
So what exactly is Wings looking for? We talked about extensively what EP needs to do, which is win the laning stage hard. What does Wings care about?
I think winning the laning phase is always something that your team's going to want to do, no matter what. It just seems like a pretty standard affair. Like, obviously, if you win your lane, some compositions will function better than others, but I think that Wings, like, mid-late game is really strong. In July, going to get caught by an Ice Path here, being chased down by the Undying. He's got that invis, though. He looks like he was walking by a sentry. I'll toss a middle lane, just doing some damage, but I do feel Wings, they don't really need to win all of their lanes.
Yep.
They just need to do well enough to where the Wisp and the Tiny can start getting their farm out in the woods.
Oh.
Maybe your Queen and back get a kill. XCD taking quite a bit of damage here, but creep block, unfortunately, for Old Chicken. Looks like the other Quill was out of range.
Does this sound crazy to say that Old Chicken could take Bristleback at level 3?
I mean, it depends on how much damage you think you're going to be taking in that level, because it doesn't take long to go from level 3 to 4. So realistically,
I'm saying taking level 3 Bristleback at 5.
Oh, at 5 instead of
because
level 3 Quills.
Honestly, you're not killing anybody with Quills.
I could see that, actually. I think it could be legit.
And you just want to reduce damage.
And it's 8% more damage reduction if you turn around before you get comboed. Yeah, I definitely could see that happening. Because most Bristleback players don't even get goo until quite a bit later, right?
Right. And you're mid. You're going to get levels anyways.
Couldn't even see the ice path there. Looks like it was off the mark.
Yep. I mean, you drop the tomb, you don't miss the kill, or you don't get the kill. It's not really a big deal. Although he's taking a ton of tower.
Is he going to die? He walks through the firefly quite a bit. Okay, that was really close. If he didn't have the decay stack, he was a goner.
All right, we're just playing it slow, playing it passive. I would be very careful kind of diving into a tiny like that, because if the Wisp was there, you get tossed under a tower. Suddenly, Wisp comes in with regen for the tiny.
Yeah.
But he knows better. Looks like double pulling is going to be attempted. No, it's just a single pull. And that's because there was a deep observer ward being dropped on the one of the deeper radiant camps. So there's no double pull from the mid lane.
That's definitely a nice little precaution to make sure that Wings don't get anything extra out of that lane. It's very common for the large camp in general just to be stacked for the Wisp in the tiny mid game, because it helps Super get six. And as soon as that Wisp comes online, that's when Wings are going to have a really good chance of stopping Energy Pacemaker from getting their five man together, if that's a strategy they plan on going for. And bottom lane, Fan could be in some trouble getting chased down here. Ice Path going to be off the mark in July, and hot pursuit here. Five stacks, a sticky napalm, and that is going to be your first blood. Tombstone dropped here in defense, but not really going to do much of anything.
And they forced in the TP from the Abaddon as well, so I mean, this should not happen, right? You don't run offensive duel lane to give up first blood. Yeah, Wings in a very, very happy position after that.
Oh, did we just ward into ward? Question is, did either team notice? I guess the Radiant one was down first, so I think Wings should have noticed, if anyone. Yeah.
Yeah. Tiny obviously wants that ward for the toss. And once you start tossing high ground without any vision, people know anyways.
I mean, do you try to go dive the Bristle? I think it's way too risky. You probably need plus one, no matter what.
Yeah. I don't think you could kill the Bristle anymore. I think what you want to do is just keep harassing him with your spell, and then just deny runes with your supports, and make him bottle crawl. Also, there's really no stacking coming out on the dire jungle, so there's no comeback mechanic, or not comeback mechanic, but a good spike of mid-game income for that Bristle back.
I mean, we're talking about spikes of income, but let's be honest, Soul Chicken's number one CS. He's 31-1.
How is he actually number one CS, though?
Bottle crow quill spam, dude. Even if you're giving one charges, if you don't die to one combo, I guess it doesn't really matter, right?
He's already level 7 with max quills, yeah.
Yeah, you're still just pushing out the wave really hard. Oh, are they going to go for a dive here? Tombstone dropped in July, trying to fly away here. He's taking quite a bit of damage. JDH throws out the fissure. Seems like that's going to be enough for the rest of Energy Pacemaker to back off. In July, even maybe thinking about re-engaging. I'm just assuming JDH fissured, by the way, because...
Yeah, he did.
He kind of lost some mana.
We'll probably see it like 25 seconds later. Although Wisp is taking quite a bit of damage. I really like the fact that Wings is helping out the safe lane Batrider. A lot of people is like, all right, Bat, you're on your own. You have Firefly. Go into the trees. But hey, man, the other lanes are doing okay. Oh, my God.
Wow, that delay.
Yeah. I mean, I don't think the Shaker going top would do much. And Tiny is at the moment okay on the mid lane. So make sure your Bat gets that early blink, because they will need it to actually start getting some kills.
But think about how fast Energy Pacemaker would have killed that safe lane tier 1 tower if Super hadn't been there. Like, if the Shaker, like JDH and Super aren't in that area, all of a sudden, there's Liquid Fire, man.
Uh-oh.
Like, that stuff is painful. Toss back here onto the creep. Chicken trying to give him the rundown.
Yeah, nice
Not
toss.
Quite fast enough. I still feel Energy Pacemaker, they're getting still quite a bit out of the lane.
Well, this bottom lane ain't doing jack. They're not even slowing down in July this far.
I mean, he's staying consistent with the Jakiro, which I guess in a way means that Wings are winning that exchange. Because
he got first blood too.
Yeah, it's an aggressive lane and he got a kill. So yeah, he's definitely winning, without a doubt.
And then Shaker's getting decent level for the fact that he's roaming everywhere. So it looks like we have a TP income for a Queen of Pain. I think it's a mistake trying to go for this kill. First, it's a big waste of time.
No, I think they can kill him. Oh, maybe not. He has 1,100 health, but he has no stick charges. That's actually pretty important.
He also doesn't have that...
Oh, never mind. He just goes back top. Yeah. He doesn't want to commit.
I think this is... Maybe you get the kill, but you just have to commit so much.
He's not really faring that great against the Viper, though, doubling up in CS.
I think it's more important...
Go for a dive? Ice Path here in July?
I think it's more important to reserve a TP to TP in the bottom lane, because they're going to be diving your tower where a Sonic Wave could actually clip just about everybody. But like you pointed out, if you don't send support here... That Liquid Fire plus Tombstone is going to work on your tower.
It's level 3 as well, so Fan getting close to decide if he wants that Macro Pie or not. I think you kind of want to get it every game. Some Jakiros don't level it. I actually think that it's really good in situations where you're kind of forcing a team to fight around one specific area. Hell, you can just even drop it on a Tombstone and be like, yeah, you can kill this, but you might take damage if you're melee.
Sure. I mean, I think it's very important for Fan to hit level 16, because I think all of his spells are excellent. Dual Breath... pretty big as well, but looks
Lasso.
Like...
Lasso?
Well, there's going to be Fissure. We'll try to hit that block, and it looks like he did.
That was such good timing, though. He prevented the Abaddon Shield from dispelling the stun. Not going to be enough, though. Soul Rip will keep him in pretty good shape.
Is the tower under deny range? It seems like it.
It is very low, yeah. It's denied here by JDH.
Yep. Mission accomplished.
Yeah, save some gold. I mean, to be honest, a Jakiro aggressive tri-lane usually can kill a tower at like 5 minutes, or maybe even less, if it's up against one hero. Super going to be spotted out here. Oh, he's going to be in trouble. He's got the tether, though. The XDD. Still a pretty slow early game. Only one kill. Wings the one on the board. But the safe lane tier one of Wings has already gone down. And Old Chicken still maintaining constant CS with this mid tiny.
Yeah, I imagine the game will remain slow unless we see EP start pressuring these early towers, which Jakiro did TP mid. With that said, though, once the Batrider gets a blink, he will start doing a lot of work. And Viper now just fully controlling the lane against Queen of Pain.
I think you just have to move around now if you blink, right? Like, you need to stop staying in that lane because you're not really getting much of anything. And speaking of nothing, poor Abaddon.
He's got boots.
Well, he has enough money for boots, but is he going to buy them?
Yeah, he needs to buy them. Alright, we just rotate the bottom lane to mid.
But it makes sense, though. Like, this is kind of what their lineup is supposed to do. They have Jakiro for a reason. Like, you don't pick Jakiro and then try to get more levels before you start pushing, I feel, because you just get free damage on the tier 1, even if you just go in for a Liquid Fire. There's going to be a stun into a Fissure.
That was the old way of playing Jakiro, right? You offlane it, you get Yules, and then you start ganking, but...
Against Wing's lineup, I don't think they can go late.
No.
Like, they need so much pressure on the map all the time. Like, this lineup needs to kill all the towers.
I definitely agree, and this is the way to start pressuring. Unfortunately, they're not getting much done. They're not getting anything done, in fact.
Yeah, it's kind of just a stare off here mid. Everyone's kind of just farming up. They will get the offlane tower, though. Old Chicken has made his way towards top. No one really from Wing's able to contest this. We check Super's level really quick just to make sure that he's close to level 6 or... All right, it's level 5.
Yep.
So not being able to stack has hurt him quite a bit. The ward is finally gone now, though. It's over 10 minutes in.
I also wonder how we're doing on the mech on the Viper, because once that's finished, you could just...
Oh, it's already done.
Okay, now you just roll towers. Oh, Earthshaker is going to offer his blood to the Viper gods.
Oh, it's blood for the blood god, man.
Okay, sure.
Come on. Skulls for the skull throne.
Is that some, like, Game of Thrones stuff?
It's Warhammer.
I'm not cultured.
It's okay, dude. Did you really ask if it was Game of Thrones?
I don't know.
You're actually my favorite person, Lemmy. I just want you to know.
You're welcome.
Energy Pacemaker. They're going down mid here. They managed to get the one kill on the Shaker, which is more than enough to force Wings back.
I don't think they're going to stop.
No, they don't even need to stop. Yeah. This is what I was saying.
Let's go.
Even though their lanes went remarkably well, let's be honest, like the Viper and the Bristleback both free farmed, so Super leaving middle lane ended up giving Old Chicken a ton of extra farm. Because instead of a Wisp and a Tiny being able to constantly pressure, you farm against the Tiny, because the Tiny can never kill you.
Right.
So I guess Super did a good thing and a bad thing simultaneously. Maybe unintentional for the side effect that it's had thus far in the game, but Energy Pacemaker, like you said, they do not want to stop.
This is some old school, like, down the mid lane, 5-man push, but obviously not starting from level 1. Fissure hitting everybody. They are running fairly low in health. Mech has been used, so gotta be somewhat careful. 2 men... Ice Path will secure that T2. Oh, Glyph and perhaps maybe a deny attempt. No Viper Strike being used just yet. Ava, no toss back.
Is he dead?
Tower is going down. Dual Breath hit everybody, and Tombstone's going to drop down as well. TP out, not going to happen here. They will get the first kill, or second kill. Fissure hitting everybody as well. I think that was an uphill miss. No, there was no miss there. Viper gets yet another kill. You go back, you heal up, and you start... Maybe looking at the other tier 2. You could go for Roshan if you like.
I think they can Rosh. I think there's at least one point in the goo, right? That should be good enough.
Yep.
And then the Bristleback also has Vanguard.
And finally, the Batrider has Blink. I mean, I think Blink could... I don't want to say stop the push, but it could break things up a little bit.
It doesn't stop the tier 2s maybe, but it will make it very hard to go up high ground. Because melee heroes like Abaddon, Bristleback, Undying, they're not so good at sieging the base. But maybe if they hit an early enough timing... Even getting lassoed might not be enough to stop them. And the Jakiro will always, like I said, get guaranteed damage with Liquid Fire. So it's just a matter of how heavily the Energy Pacemaker want to push this game. Like, do they want to just go all in and go for Rosh and go for the rest of the Tier 2s and then immediately go high ground? Because we've seen games end at around this time.
Yes, but also the EP curse, if I want to say it that, is that they're always good at doing, like, great if the first 15 minutes, and then they could take a nosedive. So if this lineup ever takes a nosedive, EP is done.
I guess there's a lot of truth to that one against Wing's lineup. The Queen and the Bat, most importantly, are very, very difficult for Energy Pacemaker to lock down in the first place.
Bottom lane, old chicken?
Nah, man, there's no way. He's so tanky. Yeah, he even had his blink on cooldown, I guess. But Super is still not 6, man. It's 13 and a half minutes in. This is a very, very slow level 6 Wisp timing.
I mean, the relocate, though, like, I guess you could split push with it.
You could have saved your tiny mid. Would have been sure, a lot better. Oh, they're going to run right into the Viper here, toss to the creep wave. He's just like, I don't even want to mess with you. Yep. Get the heck out of here.
Well, maybe they want to mess with him now. Here comes the Avalanche. So right click's going to come in. Mech's going to be used. Any TP coming in the T1 mid. It's Abaddon. Can he get here in time? It's going to be close. Looks like he will get off his spells. Where's the shield?
He's not close enough.
There's the shield. He should be fine now.
Are you serious?
Here comes the Bristleback. The Taunt's going to come in. The heal's going to come in for a second time. Viper dropping low finally will die, but they have chased out for a long, long where. Looks like TP out from one. Abaddon doesn't care because he's got ult turned on. Here comes the Queen of Pain as well. Sonic Wave will hit on the Abaddon. It looks like this team is breaking apart. Is the EP curse real?
I don't know. I think that actually ended out not terrible. Sure, they lose the Viper, but he was in a really awkward position in the first place. Like being scouted out, basically like behind the tier 1, between the tier 2, and then all of a sudden, you're just dead. Like you can't really, no matter how tanky you are, you can't expect yourself to live in that situation against multiple stuns.
Yeah, he lived a long time tanking Abaddon.
I mean, he even got a kill because I'm pretty sure Super died to corrosive damage. Like he just fell over because it hit him too many times.
Looks like Lasso is going to try to be used to initiate. Tombstone and Fissure are going to be used simultaneously. Not sure if the Batrider want to hang around, but here comes that relocate. He could go on the Jakiro. Jakiro's going to get brought down as well. And every kill that you get against this team, that's going to be a double. Every kill that you get against this team, you just buy yourself at least on time. That's huge.
And they also managed to get out with Super, so the Wisp doesn't end up going down again. He desperately needed that experience in gold, because he had not been doing so hot in the early game. He had 2 deaths. Still only halfway to level 7 right now. But I think these teamfights are... like, it's so good for Wings, because the more time Energy Pacemakers spend not pushing, the weaker their lineup will become over
yes.
time.
I'm going to say if... in the next 5 minutes, they don't remove the last T2.
It's You're done. Just saying game over? Just because I don't know if it's that extreme.
I think it's that extreme.
Okay. I mean, I do think that they have to push, no doubt. But going high ground still, with Angelai having blink, that's
No, no, I'm not telling you to go high ground. They need to get the next T2.
Either, no, I know, but yeah. I'm not like disputing what you're saying. I'm adding my own. Is even if they get the last tier 2... going high ground still is a massive choice.
That is another struggle. That we'll get to the... we'll cross the bridge when we get it.
Yeah.
Something like that? Yeah, okay.
Cross the bridge when we get to it. Just another, a little bit of chip damage here.
Another thing that they can do is also start looking at the Roshan. I don't think Wings want to fight them in there.
I think their AoE is good enough. I mean, they have Shaker ulti. They have Bat who can just Firefly
around. I mean, Attune on the high grounds and then...
yeah, that's true. If they don't kill the Undying immediately, I think it could be kind of a disaster if Wings don't get the right focus fire. But they're continuing to push. Wings finally looking to trade at least a little bit.
There's a T2. They want high ground now. Are they that desperate? Seems like it.
I don't know if it's desperation. I think it's just what their lineup is supposed to do.
Okay.
It might be desperate if they fail this push and die. Then it might be desperation.
Alright, Zombie being tossed back to the Zombie Master. They're going to go in. Ava is going to slow them down a little bit.
Look for the Isolation Fissure here from JDH. Does he have mana?
Liquid Fire, is it missing?
Yeah, he has 4 wand charges. Can he actually make the Viper get stuck in base? Because that would be really nice. Oh, he's too far away.
Alright, Tombstone is down, so...
I mean, even just that little joust that they did took a third of the tower's health.
Yep.
So you do that 1 or 2 more times, the tower dies, becomes a lot easier to just concave around the barracks and kill them.
Oh, they're not backing off. I thought, you know, Tombstone on cooldown. But I guess you could wait out the Tombstone cooldown and then come back in. There's a Batrider 4-staff, though. That's huge.
It's once every 2 creep waves, so it's not too bad. It's not a huge commitment. They're going to drop a couple of wards here up on the high ground. Yeah, the 4-staff means that they can pretty much pull anyone they want in. Super...
I think you want the Undying, right? If you could force him... if you could kill him without the Tombstone, that's a big victory for your team.
I don't know if he's ever going to be that far up. I think the best target you're going to get is Viper. I don't think you even want to
pull
Bristleback.
That's a tough kill.
It is a tough kill. Bristleback's even tougher, but I'm saying I don't think he'll be able to get anyone else. Maybe not. He does
tried.
Get Fan.
Yeah, that's a big kill if they get it. The mech's going to get used. Fan dropping low. The Ice Path, though, actually... wow, what an Ice Path. And of course, a Baton Shield is going to come through. Tombstone is going to be there as well. Relocate defensively being used. The high ground is opened up, but everybody on the Dire side is fairly low.
I guess the idea is kill fans. The push stops. Ava into toss here. Chicken getting really low. Going to see an abandoned shield pop. Looks like the rest of Energy Pacemaker wanting to retreat.
I think EP has to back off now.
Yeah,
they're
they
just
definitely
too low. Are they staying around?
Okay, they're going to get caught here if they stay too long. Blink thinking about going in.
Yep.
It's like the rest of Energy Pacemaker are running away, but...
You know what they need?
They're pursuing right now. Oh, there goes one toss. The Shaker goes in into a fissure. JDH hits on two. Another abandoned shield.
All right, that's it.
Defending that is still great for Wings, though.
Yeah.
They got a lot of damage on the tower, but not breaking base is tough. And there's also going to be an Aghanim's picked up on Queen, but we can watch this again.
Yeah, they went for Fan and... I think Abaddon...
Look at that Queen ult, man. Good God, he hit almost everyone.
But yet, nothing really happened.
Yeah, but it doesn't need to kill. That's the thing. Like, if they get Fan low, there's no more Liquid Fire, which means they can't continue the push to high ground, because that's the only way they get guaranteed damage on that Tier 3.
That's true.
So...
The big part in that fight... Actually, they never backed off. They're going to just resume this push.
Okay, so... they don't
I think
have
Wisp also died during that.
Yeah, he died.
Yeah, okay.
That looks like he got picked off there.
Okay,
chicken.
Here we go. Just the Firefly on the front line. EP, if they had a pipe, this push would have been that much easier. A lot of spells
being... Oh, he's stuck? Oh, never mind.
No.
He's not.
Okay, they're just choosing to hit. The shield's going to go on Abaddon once again. Every time I say they need to back off, they don't.
They just realized the limitations of their lineup very well. Like, it's so hard to kill the Viper or the Bristleback at this point. And that tower is in the deny range. And I don't even think Wings want to deny it, because having the tower is the buffer between your barracks just getting chipped down. And I guess Energy Pacemaker now going to take this time to maybe fake back even. They do have wards on Wings' top lane.
Can we check the goal on Jakiro or Undying? Or Viper? Okay.
Oh, looks like the game is lagged out. So.
My question is, can anybody finish a pipe on EP? If they can, you just buy it as the most... Oh.
That's some dubstep level crap going on right there, right? That was weird indeed.
If VP finish the pipe, like in the next 5 minutes, they just go high ground pipe down. Because the only way they're killing these creeps are Fissure, Avitas...
The spam,
yeah,
pretty much.
I mean, exactly why Wings was so effective last game was the early pipe on Chen. I mean, same thing here.
Yeah, same principle, I guess. A lot of spread damage. Just being able to wave clear and such. I mean, you get the... Even the Queen of Pain, I think, is almost warrant enough in of itself to think about buying Pipe. And then you also have Shaker, so just between those two, it'd be very good.
Yeah, Bristleback went for an SMY, which I think is a great item choice, but if you went for early Pipe...
What about Crimson as well? Because he has like regular Vanguard, and then he also has SMY.
Well, the problem isn't that the losing the physical damage. It's the Sonic Waves, all the spell damage that's weakening the Creep Wave.
Yeah, so. Yeah, that's fair. That's fair. Well, I think we're back in game soon. Looks like it's paused up right now. Mm-hmm. But we're having some Perfect World issues. Hopefully they're all sorted.
Another thing that you could actually get is working towards a Medallion and Solo Quest. So whenever Bristleback is just up there hitting the tower, you just give him some extra armor.
Yeah, Solar Crest is amazing high ground utility. Yeah. Like 10 armor, 30% evasion. That's like ridiculous.
Yeah, in normal cases, I think Medallion is a great pushing item as well. Not just to put on your hero, but let's say you're pushing down a T1 tower. You just put it on the melee creep that's tanking the tower shot that's running in. Obviously, in this case, it won't work like that because that melee creep is dead to all the AoE. But EP, they are not backing up. This reminds me of some kind of... It's like a Dota 1 push.
I mean, the thing is, if EP don't eventually crack base, they're in such a bad spot. Like, they've committed, what, over 5 minutes to sitting in this top lane so
Here's
far?
The thing, though. I'm feeling like it's getting to the stage where... EP, let's say if they get the T3 on the next push, and then the melee racks on the push after, it's almost like you invested so much into it that it's almost not worth it at that point.
No, I think getting the racks is worth it. I think they need the racks, like 100%.
Well, they need it. I'm not sure if they win the game off the racks is what I'm trying to say.
Oh, yeah, I agree with that, for sure.
The game ain't over. Right now, Old Chicken working on that melee. Actually, a lot of damage being done.
I mean, it's really hard to just go up and hit the Tombstone with so many heroes behind. Uh-oh. They're going to throw out an Ice Path.
Force Staff.
XCD, Relocate, used defensively as well.
That should be the melee racks now.
Yeah, this push from EP just seems to be a little bit too strong. They're going to see a little bit of a fight here. Queen ulti comes out. A lot of damage being taken from EP, but nobody dropped just yet. Injuli might be the first. He did receive that Viper Strike. Everyone in EP still standing strong. The Queen ulti is down for the time being.
Yep, whole bunch of fire on the ground. Then first, melee racks will go down. I think it's okay to back off and... Let the rest of the momentum of the way to end up getting the range racks. Because what's going to happen is EP is going to push in another lane, and that's going to demand so much attention from Wings that the top lane will eventually push in by itself.
And the melee creeps are what you want because there's obviously more of them.
Yeah. Well, that said, though, one thing that we could see Wings start doing is starting to use Relocate as a split pushing tool. Like, you just push Tiny Wisp on one lane and then Relocate back into the fight.
There's only one tier one, though. So, I mean, it's going to be a bit difficult to go for that split push. You would pretty much have to push in top because that's the lane that's going to be idly going in all the time. And you would probably have to leave your Bat and your Queen to either push other lanes or farm the woods.
Yep.
And that does leave you maybe not so susceptible to ganks, because I think Energy Pacemaker's team is really bad at ganking, but they are very good at continuing this kind of lane pressure. And looks like we're going to have a little bit more lag issues here inside of the pit. I think they were doing Roshan as well around the same time this tier 1 was going to be dropping. I seriously doubt Wings are going to try to contest this. I think it's just more, let's get the Aegis on Old Chicken, or maybe even the Viper, and then try to go for another Rex.
If they do want to contest this, they have Relocate, but doesn't seem like the case. I heard the Aegis sound.
Huh.
Okay.
All right, so Viper does get it. We're right so far. All right, let's just predict the rest of the game. All what right. happens?
Okay, EP pushes.
Okay.
The bottom lane or mid. I think bottom is a smarter choice.
Bottom is easier, yeah.
Yeah, and then they win.
That's it?
That's it.
Okay.
I mean, it's an Aegis. I think I saw Medallion being picked up on Abaddon. Hmm. Viper... Because the last fight, it didn't look like Wings was close to defending it. It wasn't close at all.
Yeah, he just put the Tombstone high ground, and there's actually no ranged hero that felt comfortable enough to go forward to hit it.
Yep.
Because they had the Yule's Ice Path. Mm-hmm. So that hero actually kind of effectively zoned them out from that situation. Now,
Is there a big item that... Hold, what just happened? They got a T2 for free?
Yeah, because they were doing Roshan. So Energy Pacemaker didn't want to go for the commitment, I guess. They didn't want to try to fight... I think it's more important for them to not take team fights to defend their own towers, mm-hmm. but to make sure that their Aegis is exchanged for a Rax. Like, that is what they need. Even being one Rax down against a Tiny who has Aghanims, like you mentioned earlier, it's just not enough. Like, they actually need to dual Rax.
Yeah. Also, I would consider using the Batrider to start cutting creep wave. Like, just hang him in the, like, right here and start cutting creep wave.
He's kind of living life on the edge, though.
He's got Blink Force.
Old Chicken's in the area. He's going to run right into Abaddon as well. Oh, wow. Did they not see him?
No, they didn't. But he ain't doing that. He's just teleporting out. And you are going to see Tiny starting to, quote-unquote, pressure the top. EP's not coming back to defend this, are they?
He does have pressure power, though. I mean, this is still...
He's out of mana. He's out of mana.
Level 2 grow.
He's got Agitrets on, man.
He can still hit the tower. He knows they're going to go in.
Yeah.
Like, this trade is actually the best thing that he can possibly do. He's got the Wisp now. If they want to relocate, they can.
Okay,
if they force Energy Pacemaker back, it's actually so bad for them. It looks like they're only going to take back one right now. It's just
and they
can
relocate mid right now if they get a jump. Looks like that's...
It's going to be tough, though. Because the Bristleback is chasing them down.
Man, we're so,
a little bit.
We're so close to mech for Wisp. He's like halfway there. If you get that mech, that could be a turning point. Like, the Tiny is just...
Oh, they're going to relocate bottom, I guess, just to split push.
Hey.
And they're going to leave the Tiny here. I think that's still okay, too.
Yeah, there you go.
Although, I don't know if you're necessarily going to be able to pressure enough. I don't think he actually leaves him here. I think he has to take him back. He has to take him back to be able to counter pressure top lane to force someone from Energy Pacemaker to go back. Because that lane isn't close enough to
I'm not sure that's quickly enough, though. Here comes EP. They're going to set up... There you go. Fissure's
okay,
going to hit...
Fissure.
Okay, Tombstone's on
that
the high
That actually blocks them completely. It's going to take so much time for that Fissure to go down.
Are they going
to
go trade Raxes? I think EP is okay for trading Raxes, are they?
Maybe.
All right, you need to pop that mech right now, and they're hitting the T3. Meanwhile, top lane looks like the T3 will be
they
dead.
They are trading.
Yeah, Dire is going to lose their first Rax. Or loses the Raxes first.
Yeah, there's only one TP on the side.
Actually,
of
is there a world?
Right now.
Is there a world where Wings could defend their melee Rax and get a Rax? Well, they just got the Rax.
The
teleported back.
Man. They're doing so much work. The Viper might have to be forced out
they
here.
Have
oh
to
no,
hold.
XDD. He teleported in the front. Okay, he's not going to be focused that hard.
Oh, here comes the Lasso, but he's got Aegis. Can you kill him twice? That's a question. He's losing a lot of health very quickly. No, he's still alive. Still alive. And Tiny taking a ton of damage down to half. Down to a quarter. They're going to try to burst him down. He's going to run into the cover of T4. And he will make it home. Thanks to that Wisp. Is anybody hitting the Raxes, though?
No one's hitting the Rax at all. In July, getting chased down, going to be forced to get himself out of there with the Force Staff. Another Fissure coming through as well from JDH. The Echo is already down. Old Chicken standing towards the front line here. Fan here as well, both below half health. Even the Viper is starting to get a little bit low. Can they continue this commitment? The Tombstone goes down. XCD might end up dropping here. Relocate, I think, comes off cooldown for Super, and he brings him back
Lord.
To the well.
They will lose the Rax, though.
Yeah, the Rax going down.
Can they pick out the Viper? Viper's stuck here a little bit.
They need to get kills for this. Like, Wings need to start killing somebody.
Batrider, it's going to Firefly around. There's an Ava, maybe a little bit of toss
Did
back
they leave
action.
Him?
Yeah, they toss him. And they leave him. Which, I think Mike
okay,
is
what's
smarter
Injulai's
choice.
Timer on Lasso? Does he have it soon? Okay,
15 seconds.
He's going to go in, try to get the
Got flame break.
Off.
Could be a break.
He's probably just going to get Yules. Okay, no, he's not going to chase.
But here's the thing. Nothing really happened in the course of the game because they traded Raxes.
Well, I mean, still being down two set of racks. If you take the mid racks, that's arguably the hardest lane to kill, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I think it's even easier to push bottom from this point out. And not really anyone from Wings. I guess they are still farming at about the same rate as Energy Pacemaker, but they've also been committing five heroes to the same lane for a very long time. So I guess they want to try to go for a counterplay here.
Yeah, they're looking for the lasso. I think I heard Firefly being used. Here it goes. Chicken's going to get focused, but he's a very, very tough kill. Stun is going on Abaddon. The Sonic Wave's going to come through, but here comes the Undying Tombstone. Now the run is going the other way, and XCD yet being focused once again. Is there a relocate? There is no relocate. I'm not sure if he has a mech. They're trying to heal him up, but XCD looks like he will go down here. Queen of Pain will blink out, and looks like they'll lose a Wisp. Is there going to be a Tether back out?
On cooldown,
he's going to be dead. Two dead. I think you just cut through mid as EP and go bottom. No, the T2 is still alive. So it looks like Wings will probably give up the T2 and defend on high ground.
In the grand scheme of things, like those deaths are really bad, but it doesn't help Energy Pacemaker end the game, if that makes sense. Like you said, they have to still go through the tier 2. I think Old Chicken is just farming mid right now, just pressuring the lane a tiny bit harder. You can see right now they have no vision pretty much of anything that's going on the side of Wings. And they're not going to even force the Tiny to buy back. I'm just curious, do they even have the power to win a 5 versus 5 anymore? I just feel like maybe
there's
Wings
an
just don't have enough
Viper.
Gas in the tank.
There's an Aghanim's on Viper.
Yeah, it's great against Wisp Tiny. When the Tiny is like the solo core, Viper becomes an even stronger hero because you can just constantly Viper strike the one target and ensure yourself that he's not going to be a threat.
It's also great in a situation like this where the Wings lineup try to wear you down by throwing out repeated AoE spells.
Yeah.
He's like, nah, man, I'm going to wear you down because Viper strike every, 12 seconds? So
it is pretty short, but I don't know if it's like the same as like Flame Break and Queen spam with an Aghanim's.
It's not, but like when the fight breaks out, Wings is not going to be full health. And that's going to be a big part of EP winning these fights. And they have Necrobook as well.
All right,
this is a push, man.
This is the make or break. Injulai looking to get a defensive Firefly down. He's going for a lasso.
That's a huge
He will
pick.
Be able to catch out the Undying. He's going to drop straight away. Fissure isolating Energy Pacemaker for the time being. Going to see an Ice Path. Land on 2 out of fam.
They really need Undying. Time to back off.
Are they going to be able to catch anyone else, though? They do have Relocate. I think they need to chase. Like, 100%, they need to go for more. But I guess they're going to be satisfied with stopping the push and then
really?
Just go ahead and back to farm.
Why do you think they need to chase?
I think the kills are important to stopping the 5-man from becoming too much. Like, when you're playing against 5-man Dota, having a level advantage can be all the difference in the world. Like, just making sure that all your heroes are 16.
But they did get a kill.
I know, but they got a kill. And it stops the Undying from getting pipe, which is a big item. I'm not saying that the kill isn't good. I'm just saying I feel like you need to be killing like 2 or 3 or maybe even more to really punish Energy Pacemaker. Because if only one dies, the lanes don't even really get de-pushed that heavily. Like, yeah, you send your Tiny to the offlane and the Wisp kill the Creep Waver 2 mid. But if you kill like 2 or 3 heroes, you have ample time to get the entire map pushed back in your favor. And that can be the difference between taking like one good fight on Energy Pacemaker's side of the map and then really dealing damage instead of looking to always trade or always defend your base.
I'm not sure if they're ever coming close to getting 2-2 kill. I'll force that back in from... Well, they're throwing everything on Viper, but he's got the mech. He's actually bound to full HP. She have a lot of heal as well. No waiting out, but the lasso back in. They could actually burst him down. There's no more healing. This could be a huge kill. He's walking away, but here comes the... I think Abaddon went off. Yeah, Viper finally goes down. Tiny's just clubbing people on the front line here. No, he's actually retreating. Not sure exactly what's killing him. Undying still on the front line. Bristleback doing all the right click in the world. Wisp finally dying as well. No, he barely survived. Double buyback coming out on the Radiant side. They really need to make this last hit, last stand. I think T3's gonna, I can't see anything. Drasko, please.
I don't know what's going on, dude. The Fortify is used. Injulai is kind of sitting here in the back, thinking about going in, trying to stack up as much napalm as he possibly can. Wings is here again, Blink is here again. He's actually going to get relocated in. Looks like he threw out an ulti. No one on the side of Energy Pacemaker going down. Old Chicken just going ham on the barracks. Doesn't care about anything. Injulai just trying to get some damage dealt, putting a Firefly down, force staffs himself to safety. Melee barracks taking a lot of damage here. Blink in. He wants to try to go for the Abaddon. Doesn't quite get him. Soul Rip on the shield to keep him alive. BKB now popped by the Queen of Pain. Old Chicken just still hitting the racks. Is he actually going to go back for Megas or is he just going to run away?
No, he's running away right now. There's still two. Down. Looks like Abaddon's gonna go down.
But whatever.
That was a zoning macro player, yeah. By the way. In case anybody was wondering.
So I think EP now, with all these Raxes down, they just wait for the next Roshan, and then you steal the deal.
I don't even think they need to wait. That Bristleback has a heart. Like, Old Chicken is huge.
How did he get so much farm?
I mean, the Wisp left mid, that's how he got so much farm.
Well,
that's the trade-off that they made. So Energy Pacemaker didn't really look to necessarily win their lane super hard, but they applied enough pressure bottom with their aggro tri-lane that it made Super and JDH just kind of hang around there for a long time. And both of those heroes are so level-starved.
Yeah.
Like, you want Shaker and Wisp to both be at least level 6. And if you don't have that, like, they blocked the large camp, so Super couldn't go in the jungle with XTD and get that really nice creep stack going to be able to hit 6 at a faster time. Like, what, he hits 6 at 14 minutes? Like, that is incredibly slow.
Mm-hmm. I do want to say that if EP made this push in 6.83, it was not working.
Oh, no, not even close.
Because all the gold they got from the Raxes is,
like, that
so
would have been
huge.
Like a 10k gold swing or something when they defend base, like, once by killing two heroes, and then all of a sudden it is impossible for them to win. But yeah, I do think the patch made this lineup possible.
And that's really good to see. I mean, I'm not seeing this kind of pushing style for a long, long time.
Now, there's that Solar Crest you were talking about earlier. Going to be able to pop it on Old Chicken. How in the hell are they going to kill Old Chicken with a Solar Crest on him?
They're not. They probably ignore him in the last fight. Like, they were chasing for kills.
But he still hits really hard. Like, just having a heart and an SNY with your ulti stacked, like, you still hit for well over 200 damage, and that's only 3 stacks.
I mean, I guess you hope the Bristleback dive really hard into the base to zone people out.
You mean like the well?
No, well, yeah, and then you lasso him into the well. That's the only way.
And then he gets Solar Crested and still doesn't die.
Well, he tries to walk back out of the well, and then Tiny toss him back into the well again.
Okay. No, like, you toss to Wisp, who's relocating to another well that's behind that well.
That's sick.
Wellception. All right, so Energy Pacemaker looking to potentially seal the deal here in game number 2. Tie up the series 1-1. Well played. So here we go. Tiny finishing up an Assault Crest. Oh, blink on Shaker. I don't know if it's going to be enough, but they could try to make something happen.
That Viper Strike is just saying no.
It actually just made them Mega, because Injuli couldn't go in to get any defense off on the
Not
Rax.
Mega yet. One more Rax up top.
Oh, yeah, they have Range Rax. So.
All right, this Phaedra's got to cut them off. No cutting off just yet. They're going on the Bristleback. Oh, here comes the Echo. Is it going to hit on anybody? He's just standing there. He Phaedra's. The dagger gets canceled. So, okay, this is going to be Megas.
Yeah, I think this is the beginning of the end here for Wings in game 2. They're trying all they can. Fire everywhere, Macropires and Fireflies. He lassoed the Bristleback, and he immediately got dispelled with the Aethotic Shield.
Yep.
There is just nothing they can do. They're going for the last play out here.
I like the attempt. I really do.
Look at how no damage that hero is taking. He can't die.
He's body blocking for
Save
the Wisp.
Save the Wisp.
Right. Wisp is a bus home, so.
All right, I gotta say, Energy Pacemaker, they had their good early game, and they didn't lose it.
I really like this. Like, this is a cheese, right? Like,
I mean, it is kind of a cheese. I think the Jakiro made it a cheese, actually.
Yeah.
But it doesn't mean that, okay, when people refer to something as a cheese, it's actually just so obnoxiously good that they think it's unfair. So that's why they call it a cheese. But doesn't that just mean you drafted really well?
They did. They did draft really well, right?
I mean, I agree.
Yeah.
I would call it a cheese if it happened to me, because it's really good.
Now we get to look at Queen of Pain not pushing out this wave.
I mean, those creeps are pretty durable. What do they have, like over 1,000 health apiece or something like that? Yeah, 1,200.
Nice scream.
Decent. So what, you have to scream those things like 5 or 6 times to kill them?
Queen of Pain doesn't even have that much money.
All right, this is what you do. You sell your BKB.
He's getting Maelstrom.
I was just about to say
that. That is
Maelstrom.
The right way, yep. But I don't think she should have got BKB in the first place.
You can't sell BKB anyway, so it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
I don't know. I mean, what else could he have bought that would have mattered? Oh, you know what? He might have even been able to buy a book. I think Mana Burn is super underrated on Wing's team. Like, if you Mana Burn the Undying or the Abaddon, for example, like, them just not having any mana to dispel.
I think they had multiple Arcane Boots.
Do they have one or two?
They have two, I think. What a smoke.
No, yeah, they do have two, okay.
Yeah.
Maybe not. Maybe he wouldn't have time to farm it.
What is going on up top right now? I mean, I like the fact that Wing's just not GGing out. They're keeping things afloat.
I mean, it's a TI5 qualifiers. You don't GG unless you absolutely know you can't win, right?
Uh-oh, this could be bad. Toss up. The tomb's going to get dropped down, and if both of these dies... okay, there's a relocate.
Sacrificing himself for the greater good.
Hey, man. They're pushing out the base. Is somebody getting a Vlad's?
I think the Super would buy it, right?
Well, not one. He should die. He should buy it before he dies. Oh, no, he's saving for buyback, I guess.
He's fine.
No, he's definitely not fine. He just died.
Yeah, I'm kind of wondering if there's any different itemization that really could have changed the game in any meaningful way for Wings.
I definitely think that BKB was a mistake. And the 4 staff, perhaps.
On the queen.
Yeah. I think the 4 staff also perhaps is a mistake. Cause
on the Batrider, really?
No, on the Shaker.
Oh, okay.
Because at this point, you could get tossed into the middle of a clump.
Wait, the Shaker doesn't have a 4 staff. What?
Sorry, the blink on Shaker is a mistake, and the BKB on the Quap is a mistake, in my opinion. But hindsight is 20/20, right?
Yeah, of course. I think in general, people want to buy BKB against 5-man Dota because it means that you can always go aggressive if you're queen. Like, you can just blink into the middle of those heroes, but I don't think they're as reliant on physical damage. And here we go. Energy Pacemaker getting down one tier 4.
There is no fight. There's a pipe as well.
Yeah.
Well, they're going to dump some damage on the Viper. Shrugs it off. Here comes a big aggro. They're going to drop a small 2 Thunder in about half health and then proceed to everybody die. Macropire doing a lot of work on XDD. Relocate back out, but yeah.
I think it was just for him. There we go. There's a GG coming out from Wings. Ultimately, a draft that we talked about very early on, having the potential to just straight up take all the towers and end the game.
Yep.
And that's pretty much what they did. It wasn't the quickest 5-man death ball strategy we've ever seen. Took them around 38 minutes to win the game, but it was definitely effective.
Considering the fact that they gave up first blood on the bottom lane to the Batrider,
yep,
could have got ugly really fast, but it didn't. They controlled it, and EP won the game as predicted, right? You're asking me when we were logging out, or when we were lagging out?
Well, to be fair, you said that they were going to go bottom and then win the game.
Win the game.
But they didn't go bottom and win the game straight away.
Yeah. But eventually they did.
Eventually.
Welcome back, Cinderin and Gods. That game was quite decidedly a very different game from game one.
Always interesting to see a game like that. Kind of like you mentioned, it's kind of a classic old school strategy and they made it work. I think it would have worked a lot easier if they got the pipe like
much earlier.
Yeah, much earlier. They had like one of their supports farming and he didn't get it until they'd already taken the top racks as well. I think they were even taking the mid racks before the pipe was finished. It was like after they traded racks where Undying finally got it. And maybe someone like the Bristleback or the Viper should have gone for it instead. It was nice having the Ag Scepter, but that first push at top took as long as it did because they didn't have a pipe. But hey, it worked.
I think the Aghanim's Viper crushed that lineup so hard just because XCD could never do anything. Like, even if he gets relocated in, he either gets Yules into an ice path or he gets Viper struck. And either way, he just stands there and just throws out one Avitas, and then it's like, okay, well, I get relocated back now.
Yeah, the Abaddon was definitely an amazing pick as well. Like, I was thinking, like, okay, what here? Like, get like Avenger, something to do with the Batrider Lasso, but Abaddon does that, but also heals, keeps everyone sustained, kept the Viper alive countless times.
Would a Dazzle have done the same thing in that lineup, or do you think Abaddon was stronger?
Dazzle doesn't break the Lasso.
Yeah, I know, but that's what I mean. Would it still have been as good? Because I think Dazzle's better sustain, maybe better 5v5, but the Abaddon stops in July from ever doing
I think the big difference is you cannot Lasso the support.
Yeah.
You can't lasso Abaddon.
Okay.
You could definitely lasso the Dazzle and just like, hey, man, you don't push now.
I think they're different because Dazzle would help with like the AoE damage, whereas Abaddon's great against the single target burst damage.
Yeah.
It's kind of two different styles. I think it could have still worked, though.
Yeah. Going into this game, I said, or when it was picked in the draft, rather, I said I didn't think Jakiro was a good pick. It did work out very well in the end. I think I underestimated it a bit, how they made it work in the lineup, so I might have to eat my words a little bit on that. But in addition to that, I also want to say, I really think Shaker is not the kind of pick against this kind of lineup. That is just not a good hero.
He delayed it a lot, though, with what he got, like the fissure to block the ramp and everything.
Yeah, it buys time, but it never, like, you buy time, but you never win, right? Do you know what I mean? You're just delaying the inevitable. I think Caudle actually wasn't banned in that game.
It wasn't.
And with Caudle, you have twice as good split push with Io Tiny. You can just recall back. Like, you create havoc everywhere in the map. You hold the first towers, because whenever Jakiro goes to liquid fire the tower, you mana leak. And then he either has to stand there and take a beating, or he has to run away, and then he can't keep going in all the time.
Blinding Light would be insane.
Blinding Light owns Bristle.
Yep.
Then he can't go high ground and hit the towers. And ultimately, the Shaker didn't really, like, he didn't accomplish much, because this was not a game in which they were, like, combining their spells very much. It was, like, one Death Ball strat versus like a split push strat, more or less, or like a skirmishing strat. And I don't think Shaker was the pick. I think Abaddon was really, really good. The last two picks for EP kind of set up the strat, and then the Shaker for me was an off pick. I have this feeling that Jakiro would not have looked as good if their last pick would have been a better one.
Okay.
A lot of these Shaker picks just... Yeah. In general, I feel like the teams that are picking Shaker are not picking it for the right reasons in these games. I haven't seen a good Shaker game this tournament, I think, yet. It's like, it's always mediocre. There's never, like... These wow, Shaker really won them the laning stage, or this amazing roaming just owned the mid lane and he got a blink dagger like minute 20. Every Shaker has to sell his boots to get a blink dagger minute 40 in this tournament. Like,
yeah.
Pick another hero then.
And that's the thing. They didn't have any farm going towards him. And like, a Cotto would have been great. I think even like a Sand King would have been more reliable.
Sand King a lot better too.
They're grouping up as five. Sand King has plenty of time where he can go farm lanes and get a decent timing on his blink dagger before they go for Rax. So.
He would have been a great alternative. Also jungles. Again, they could probably easily get away with the jungle of this game, I guess.
What did you guys make of the Wisp Tiny lane and the fact that Super decided to prioritize bottom maybe a little bit, maybe too much? Maybe it was the right call to stop them from killing the tier 1 tower super early because, you know, when did you have Jakiro? He was already level 5 by that point, I believe, and he could have just went mid, kept killing towers. I feel like if Old Chicken didn't have an amazing middle lane, like staying consistent farm with the Viper on his team who was safe lane against a Quap and a Tiny, then maybe it could have been a bit different.
I think you need to beat the Bristle in this game. It's also what I said from the start. Like when it comes to the laning, I was like, they're not going to put Bristle mid because he doesn't win against Io Tiny. But if you just let Bristle get a free lane, it's great. And that hero, in a lineup like this, when you're playing Deathball, you want some sort of hero that can go in front that you really can't target down. And it's either Viper or the Bristle. Bristle is the absolute most tanky hero in the game for pushing towers. You engage, and if there's any way you could turn your back, even if you can, you just get an Aphotic Shield and then you turn your back. Like they were never able to target him out like they wanted. And if they shut down the Bristle back, even if Viper gets complete free farm, I don't think the base siege is going to go down that well. Viper doesn't hit buildings hard. He hits heroes with Viper Strike. Getting buildings takes a very long time. You need to get them low first so another toxin starts kicking in. I think that was a big mistake.
Okay.
They needed to shut the Bristle down.
All right. Well, I guess that means like between the first and the second game, obviously completely different strategies. So Cinderin, you think the Shaker is not really a hero that has any, maybe it has a place, but just not in the way that we've been seeing it?
I think it definitely has a place, but generally, I feel like the Shakers just don't get enough done in the early game. It's a lot of like moving from lane to lane and not really accomplishing anything. They're like, it's like they're looking for a purpose, but they never really find one in the game. And then in the late game, you're like, now I only have one purpose, which is the Echo Slam, so I'll just sell all the items I fought really hard to get one Blink Dagger initiation. If that wins, great. If not, I tried. So get something more active. Or if you want to run the Shaker, really make use of ganking the mid lane early or getting Fissure blocks in the safe lane and getting kills. Like, just look for kills early. And then ultimately, if these kills are successful, you will get Arcane Boots fairly quickly. And then you can actually farm the jungle. Shaker isn't that bad. With a couple of points in Aftershock, one in Enchant Totem, you can farm the jungle fairly easily. Yeah. And then you get your Blink minute 20 or 25 instead of 40.
I think where we saw him be successful was back when we had like the Shadow Fiend versus Sniper mids during DAC, whatever it may be. But you look at the core heroes these teams are picking, be it Viper, Bristleback in this game. What's Shaker doesn't do anything against these heroes. His damage output doesn't really help bring them down. His laning presence is next to non-existent, and that's what you need, strong laning supports or at least ganking supports. So
yes.
I think it'd be good if teams were still picking like the Shadow Fiend versus Sniper type mid matchups, but that's just not a thing anymore.
Well, even in the games where we have like Shadow Fiend versus Storm, it still feels like the Shaker isn't accomplishing
much for either side.
So, but I would definitely agree. Like, out of all the Shaker picks we've seen in the tournament, a lot of them were picked like early first phase, sometimes early in the second phase. This was a fifth pick that didn't counter the opponent's strategy. So in this kind of game, definitely a no-go for me. But
okay. All right. With that said, this is series is now tied up 1-1. Energy Pacemaker, bringing it back. So what'd you predict? You predict 2-0, right?
Yeah.
Me too. So we're out.
I still do. I believe in...
How does that work?
All right, tune in a couple of minutes to watch Wings get a 2-0 on game 3.
Energy Pacemaker was discovered that they cheated in that game, and they get a death loss.
Ah, okay. There you have it.
All right.
If I'm right, you owe me something. That would be like the sickest...
We're going to play pool at some point. You can take it out on me there.
All right, that's good.
We'll be back.
Always taking towers. Fissure here on the fan. He gets tossed up to the high ground. What a play! Are you kidding me?
We're not even at TI5 yet. This is just the qualifiers.
This is a pocket strat. Okay, he's actually losing this right now. He's going to have to blink down.
I think this is better. I think this is vastly better.
I don't think he even want to
pull
Bristleback.
That's a tough kill.
It is a tough kill. Bristleback's even tougher, but I'm saying I don't think he'll be able to get anyone else. Maybe not. He does
tried.
Get fan.
Yeah, that's a big kill if they get it. The mech's going to get used fan, dropping low to ice path, though. Actually, wow, what an ice path. And of course, a Baden shield is going to come through. Tombstone is going to be there as well. Relocate defensively being used. The high ground is opened up, but everybody on the Dire side is fairly low.
They're doing so much work. The Viper might have to be forced out
they
here.
Have
oh
to
no,
hold.
XDD, he teleported in the front. Okay, he's not going to be focused that hard.
Oh, here comes the last up, but he's got Aegis. Can you kill him twice? That's a question. He's losing a lot of health very quickly. No, he's still alive, still alive. And Tiny taking a ton of damage down to half, down to a quarter. They're going to try to burst him down. He's going to run into the cover of key four, and he will make it home thanks to that whisp. Fire blocking use. Here he goes. Chicken's going to get focused, but he's a very, very tough kill. Stun is going on Abaddon. The Sonic Wave's going to come through, but here comes the Undying Tombstone. Now the run is going the other way, and XCD yet being focused once again. Is there a relocate? There is no relocate. I'm not sure if he has a mech. They're trying to heal him up, but XCD looks like he will go down here. Queen of Pain will blink out, and looks like they'll lose a Wisp. Is there going to be a Tether back out?
On cooldown,
he's going to be dead. Two dead. I think you just cut through mid as EP and go bottom. No, the T2 is still alive.